This episode is brought to you by Brilliant. Hello, cadets. We have a special episode for you today. Today, we're going to answer a question that's probably itching inside of your beautiful head. What is blockchain? What does blockchain have to do with an Excel spreadsheet? We'll walk you through exactly what blockchain is, how it works, why it works, and what to expect from the immediate future. Get your popcorn. It's gonna be juicy stuff. I'm Captain Crypto. Welcome to Cryptonauts.
Cryptonauts.
The two words block and chain sound so dissimilar that making sense of them together is hard. But the actual concept behind blockchain is really simple. Blockchain is just a fancy way of saying a database with the same collection of information repeated across multiple computers. By database, we mean it's as simple as a spreadsheet, like this Excel spreadsheet. You input values, and values can be updated over time. So far, so good. With a spreadsheet, I can share it with my friend Bob and Adam and Sam. When a spreadsheet has a million lines of data, it's considered a database. Large databases are saved on servers, and servers are just computers dedicated to the sole job of storing and updating data. So to repeat, a huge spreadsheet is like a database, which is stored in a dedicated server. Let's say database A is copied to a server or multiple servers that they control and that people update it on a daily basis. That server is considered centralized. When database A in a server is copied over and over again to different servers controlled by different people, that database is considered decentralized. However, we run into issues when two people take database A and make their own versions of it, database AB and database AC. Let's say Bob updates the amount of Bitcoin he has to, say, 5 Bitcoins, but Adam uses his copy to say Bob only has 1 Bitcoin. Which database is correct? We need a way to make sure all database copies are in sync and to validate which copy is correct. That's where blockchain technology comes in. So, I have here a bunch of foam cubes and a little baby box. Each of these colored cubes represent a transaction. For simplicity's sake, each transaction records the transfer of one Bitcoin from one person to another. That's what this squishy cube means. This box represents a package of transactions. You grab a handful of transactions and stuff them into a box. Boom, there you have it. You now have a block. This block contains new information, specifically a record of transactions. So every 10 minutes, a new block with brand new transactions are formed. This is where the chain in blockchain comes in. Let's say that this box is A1. And now this box is B2. And this one is C3. To make it a chain, we just say B2 is connected to A1 and C3 is connected to B2. This number here is called a hash. This way, if we want to find A1, we just follow this hash all the way down. In reality, the Bitcoin blocks have very long hashes, but each one is connected to the one before it. So we can actually go all the way back to Bitcoin's very first block here. So who exactly creates blocks? We'll give a brief overview here, but if you'd like to know more about the process, check out our video, Proof of Work versus Proof of Stake, here. Okay, so a block is actually generated by something called a miner. A miner is just a really fast computer. Let's say all of these 12 magic cubes represent miners. Bitcoin uses what's called proof of work, and a miner has to earn the right to produce a block for the Bitcoin blockchain. If a miner succeeds, then they're rewarded with Bitcoin. Proof of work is just a fancy way of saying, I solved a magic puzzle. These 12 magic cubes, aka miners, are trying their best to solve the puzzle as quickly as possible. Usually this process takes 10 minutes, or if there are only 4 miners or 1,000 miners, the difficulty of the puzzle would always equate to being solved in around 10 minutes. Boom, solved it. This miner now produced a block that gets recorded and gets rewarded with several Bitcoins for their hard work. To sum up the process of a Bitcoin transaction, let's say you send 1 Bitcoin to me, Captain Crypto. The transaction is transmitted to a network of miners, and the miner that wins the puzzle in 10 minutes gets to take your transaction to produce a block. Then that block is included at the front of the blockchain, which is made of thousands of blocks before it. After 10 minutes, your transaction is complete, and everyone now has the true history of all Bitcoin transactions. The great thing about blockchain is that it's very transparent and secure. Anyone can go back in time and look up transactions. Regarding security, if someone wanted to go back in time and tamper with transactions on the blockchain, they would have to expend a huge amount of energy to do so. You would actually need over 51% of the total hash power, meaning if there are 10,000 Bitcoin miners, you would need to control 5,100 miners. That's very costly, so most miners would rather just mine Bitcoin and support the blockchain instead of tampering with it. We mostly talked about blockchain and how it applies to Bitcoin, but blockchain can be used much more than just cryptocurrencies. There are talks of using blockchain technology in democratic elections. The difficulty in tampering with blockchains is the main selling point when it comes to having secure elections on the blockchain. Other applications for blockchain include product inventories, state identities, deeds to homes, healthcare records, and more. Here are the advantages of using blockchain technology. Accuracy. Because there are no humans involved in the process of creating blockchain records, there is no room for human error. Cost reductions. You can get rid of a lot of third-party costs if you run things through the blockchain. For example, documents can be easily verified without a notary. If you're a business accepting credit card payments, you won't need to pay a fraud fee. Decentralization, because as information is spread across a network, it becomes almost impossible to tamper with this information. Transaction speed, you can get $1 million sent to you and approved in only 10 minutes, whereas it would take days and maybe even weeks to get that amount or larger approved with regular banks. Finally, one of the biggest advantages of blockchain is the ability to provide banking services to nearly 2 billion adults that do not have bank accounts or any means of storing money. In developing countries, these people could live miles away from the nearest bank, and any cash they have has to be saved in their homes. But with a cheap cell phone, they can have immediate access to cryptocurrencies and their benefits. While blockchain can sound amazing, it's definitely not perfect. There are some things that are really not great about it. We actually have a whole video discussing possible disadvantages of blockchain and how smart people are trying to mitigate those disadvantages. Check out this link up here or in the description. But we'll get into the top two disadvantages here. First, there's a heavy cost for using blockchain technology because proof of work requires millions of miners running 24/7 to validate blocks. The electric consumption is comparable to that of Denmark, with estimated costs of $5,000 to $7,000 per Bitcoin generated. However, Bitcoin mining farms are moving towards renewable energy solutions like solar power, natural gas, and power from wind farms. Second, blockchain can be slow. For Bitcoin specifically, on average, only 2,790 transactions can be approved every 10 minutes, compared to 24,000 transactions per second by Visa. Bitcoin is a snail. There are other blockchains and cryptocurrencies that are developing faster transaction times, close to 30,000 transactions per second, but at the cost of decentralization. You see, the faster you want your blockchain to be, the more centralized it has to become, and the more it can be manipulated by a controlling faction. In any case, please check out our video to dive deeper into the shortcomings of blockchain as stated by critics. Alright cadets, I hope this video has helped you to learn what blockchain is. If you liked it, please subscribe and share this video with your friends and family. Big shout out to Brilliant.org for sponsoring this episode. There's a lot we didn't cover in this episode about blockchain technology, so if you'd like to learn more, check out the cryptocurrency course on Brilliant.org. They detail what hashes are, how blockchain security works, and why smart contracts are important. However, if you'd like to learn about other topics, Brilliant has something for everybody. Whether you want to start at the basics of math, science, and computer science, or dive into cutting-edge topics like artificial intelligence or quantum computing. If you'd like to join me in a community of 8 million learners and educators today, click the link in the description down below or visit brilliant.org/cryptonauts. Remember to HODL, secure crypto, and may Satoshi and Vitalik be with you always.